Hi there. I'm Shannon Gregory of Microcell Sciences. We do live and layered blood cell microscopy, and we have 9 locations for you to choose from the Toronto area all the way through to the Ancaster area. What I wanted to discuss with you today, it's Lyme Awareness Month, and I find Lyme disease a really imperative thing to be talking about. Today I'm going to be showing you a video of what Lyme disease looks like in live blood cell, as I do find live blood cell is an amazing tool for all of us to look at the intracellular parasites that does reside in the blood due to tick bites, mosquito bites, things like that. Because it's Lyme Disease Awareness Month, I want everybody to be aware we need to be much more precautionary things to be happening in regards to ticks, such as wearing long pants and certainly bug spray. If you're camping and things like that, you need to make sure that if you do get a tick bite, that you do go and have some antibiotics through our Western medicine, as it does carry a lot of different bacteria. So what I wanted to show you today, everybody always asks me what Lyme disease looks like in the blood, and everybody is a little different. There's always different pathogens that we do see. However, I do have a video here showing a lot of different parasites that do enter from the tick and what it carries. So I'm going to show you a little video and discuss kind of what we have here, and hope you guys like it. So here's a video here. I'm just going to turn my camera to my screen right there, and I'm going to press pause. And basically what we have here is a whole bunch of parasites you're seeing on screen. So here's quite a long bacterial strand. Now there's another little parasite in the corner here. In regarding to ticks, unfortunately, because they do bite animals and things like that, and they do live in the soil, they do carry an enormous amount of different type of parasites and bacteria. These big white blobs that you're seeing here is your immune system. And in this particular case, the immune system is overwhelmed with all of the different parasites we're seeing and bacteria here. Therefore, it's not active and moving. This is something that we can definitely help treat, as modern medicine, unfortunately, isn't really looking for these type of co-infections. There's many different tests you have to take to be able to actually see these pathogens firsthand. And because live cell will use actual microbiology in conjunction with live cell, we're seeing a lot more, as our tech at Microcell is very, very good, and ultimately we're running 4K. As you can see, we've got quite a large parasite there. This is a bacterial component over in the corner here. We've got more kind of parasites, another immune response over here. We have some biofilms that unfortunately are created, as your body's job is to generally protect bacteria. We can also see numerous type of cockal or strep throat type of indications, which unfortunately, again, a lot of ticks do carry a lot of caucus type of indications, a lot of caucus type pathogens, which of course is very bloodborne and is passed through the ticked animal. So upon saying this, I want everybody to really be aware, check their body, things like that when they are camping or, you know, going for a walk in the woods, things like that. It also can unfortunately be on a pet, and then the tick bites you. So I think we're in a little bit of a different position these days, as ticks are definitely on the influx. So I hope everybody liked this video. It gives you a little idea of what Lyme looks like in the blood. Please go to microcell.com if you're interested in having your blood looked at for any of these issues. And we'll talk to you really soon. Thank you.